If you're just joining us, here are the 8 things you need to know today. Investigators in New Hampshire continue to look into the cause of a massive explosion at the New Hampshire ball bearings plant in Peterborough. 15 people were sent to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries yesterday. State Fire Marshal's office is looking at a chemical reaction as a possible cause for that blast. The York County Courthouse will reopen this morning after a bomb scare shut it down yesterday. Police evacuated the area for a few hours while bomb-sniffing dogs searched for any signs of an explosive, but ultimately found nothing. Well, it has been 15 years since 15-year-old Ashley Willette's body was discovered in Scarborough. The case has gone unsolved, but WMTW News 8's Norm Karkos tells us the family is still hoping someone will come forward with some information. Good morning, Norm.
And good morning to you, Megan. That's right. Dozens of people gathered outside of Ashley's high school last night in front of Thornton Academy as a memorial bench was unveiled there. Now, the teenager was last seen at a friend's house back in 1999. Police have not arrested anyone in connection with the case. Organizers say they are now hoping to spark new interest, and Ashley's family is hoping for some closure now. Scarborough police are urging anyone with information to give them a call. The family is also pushing for a proposal being considered by lawmakers to create Maine's first cold case homicide unit. A bill that would create that unit in the Attorney General's Department is currently making its way through the committees at the state capitol. Live here in the studio, Norm Karkos, WMTW News 8.
If you live in York County, you may be getting a call today from the Emergency Management Agency, which is testing out its new Code Red system. It's similar to Reverse 911. It notifies residents in case of an emergency. And for more information on the program or to register a phone number, head to the As Seen On section of our website, WMTW.com.
And continuing the 8 things that you need to know today, the installation mass for Maine's new bishop, Robert Dealey, will be celebrated this Friday at 2 p.m. at the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception right here in Portland. And if you'd like to attend the ceremony, you will need to get some tickets in advance as there is limited seating. Dealey will replace Bishop Richard Malone, who accepted the position as Bishop of Buffalo, New York. The University of New England is hosting its annual career fair for health professionals today at its Portland campus. That's going to be from noon until 4 p.m. at the Finley Recreation Center. Organizations including the Maine Veterans Homes, Maine Health, and Mercy Hospital will be hiring. The fair is free and it's also open to the public. Kraft has announced it is removing artificial preservatives from its most popular individually wrapped cheese slices, Kraft Singles. Sorbic acid in the cheese will now be replaced with a natural ingredient which prevents mold. And finally this morning, some sad news. We learned that legendary actress Shirley Temple has passed away. Temple is best remembered for her Depression-era films like Curly Top and The Littlest Rebel. She was 85 years old. Matt, so many good movies. Heidi, one of my favorites.